measuring hip flexion, you'll want your patient in a supine position. The axis of your goniometer will be on the greater trochanter, the movement arm aligned with the lateral aspect of the epicondyle of the femur, and the stationary arm along the lateral aspect of the trunk. Rachel, please perform hip flexion for me. Here we're looking at 100 degrees of hip flexion for this measurement. Measuring hip extension, patient will be in a prone position. Axis of the goniometer will be on the greater trochanter of the femur. Movement arm aligned with the lateral aspect of the epicondyle of the femur, and the stationary arm aligned with the lateral aspect of the trunk. Rachel, perform hip extension for me, please. Rachel should bring her leg up, and we are looking at 15 degrees of extension. Measuring hip internal and external rotation. Patient will be in a seated position, knee hanging off the table at approximately 90 degrees. Axis of the goniometer will be on the patella. Stationary arm will align perpendicular with the ground, and the movement arm will be along the shaft of the tibia. Rachel, could you perform hip external rotation for me, please? Here we're looking at 25 degrees. Okay, Rachel, now could you perform hip internal rotation? And here we are looking at 45 degrees. Measuring hip abduction with your patient in supine position. The first thing you want to do is find the ASIS on both sides. If we were to measure this leg, then I would find the ASIS and I would place the axis of the goniometer right over the ASIS, and then the stationary arm lined up with the opposite ASIS, and then the movement arm would be following the patella. Now keep in mind, we are following the red scale for this measurement. Now Rachel, if you could bring your hip into abduction. Line it up with the patella, and here we are looking at 30 degrees of abduction. Measuring hip adduction. Patient will be in a supine position. Once again, find the ASIS on both sides. If we were to measure this leg, then we will want the axis of the goniometer to be over this ASIS. The stationary arm will line up with the opposite ASIS, and the movement arm will align with the patella. For this measurement, we will be using the red scale on the goniometer, and to perform hip adduction, we will need it to come inward. So to perform this range of motion, we need the opposite leg to come into abduction. So Rachel, please bring the left leg into abduction, and now bring the right leg into adduction. Line that up with a patella. Using the red scale, we are looking at 20 degrees of adduction.